Stand up straight.
I'm Joey Warner.
Sorry, I should have given.
And Murray Lumley.
Yes, that's what I wanted to order, yes.
Radical.
Radical.
Okay, so we're gonna, there we go.
This is our banner woman. Where is
Wayne Robinson?
Oh. She got the banner?
Hey, hey.
Oh, here's
ho,
the
ho, John Cratan's got to go. Hey, hey.
Carolyn Robinson.
My way.
We don't have pictures of our doors and stuff.
Hey, what happened to? What just happened? What did you
do? Oh, the gates just opened by themselves. Excuse me, sir. Thank you.
Welcome.
Well, good morning or good afternoon. We are here today for many different reasons. I think there's many, many reasons why we oppose the bombing of Yugoslavia and our own government, their involvement in it. First of all, there are many people here who have protested against violence on principle, any kind of violence, who have been protesting for more than two decades. But a lot of us are here simply because it is a fact, and it has been since day one, that the bombing of Yugoslavia has only, the only result of it has been further death and destruction. And now Canadians have to ask themselves, do they want to pay for bombs that are going to land and kill civilians? Because that's what's happening right now. And if they don't, then they should make their objection heard very strongly. And we also provide viable alternatives and solutions to this crisis. Because the fact is, this is not a last resort. Serious negotiations have never been tried. And what has to happen immediately and unconditionally is the bombing must stop, because you cannot negotiate with someone while you're bombing them. That's just plain common sense. And that's also the international laws governing the way conflict resolution should be held. Bombing must stop immediately. Negotiations must be held. And the military cannot be involved in that in any way whatsoever. We cannot allow NATO or any other kind of military to determine what the structure of negotiations are going to be. And it has to be serious negotiations. It cannot be demands. So we need to involve the world's civilian bodies, civil society, in this debate. And we have to drive home the fact that I constantly say this the past month, but I am deeply ashamed to be a Canadian. Deeply ashamed to be a Canadian. And, excuse me. See, I caught that standing out here every Friday.
Well, I've been sick forever, too,
right?
That's
right, you have
to. Right? Okay.
Then Jesus, when Jesus was betrayed and arrested, one of the people there was to be around, took up a sword, grabbed a sword and chopped off the one of the slave's ears. And he said, then Jesus said to him, put your sword back into its place. For all those who take up the sword shall perish by the sword.
What's been going on the last few weeks?
Who's bombing, I guess.
What's been happening the last few weeks here?
Let's do something.
Media side.
Here in Hamilton?
Yeah.
Well, we're trying. I think we're kind of increasing, which is kind of encouraging to see. There are a bit more people than the last time. I think we're getting the communities integrated, which is not too bad, and just, you know, general awareness about what's going on in Yugoslavia and what is Canada doing with it, and, you know. I think it's, I'm hoping for success, you know, whatever that means.
Do you like the money?
I don't think it was there.
Where are all you people?
Are they in there?
Don't do that.
Oh, really? Okay.
Don't, baby.
No,
thank
you.
All
this
right.
Is a federal office, and we're trying to get some work done.
Okay.
Hi.
No.
Is Dan in today?
No, actually, he has some students today, so he's in for later on.
Huh?
Maybe.
I don't know.
Because one woman just has a petition to handle.
Okay, we'll take it for him. Yeah, no problem.
You know, what
car?
Are you
good?
I'm trying to get
to
the
okay.
Hey.
Okay.
Hey.
Okay.
Hey.
You're
going to have a petition.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you have
I will.
He's not in, and he's not going to be in.
in Ottawa?
Yeah, it's his turn to stay.
Oh.
One Friday,
I'm asking
for the
host
meeting.
Well, I knew they were in Ottawa.
Yeah,
week.
Yeah.
I was at a town hall meeting with John Bryden Monday night, and he left. Thanks. He'll leave during the meeting, go back to Ottawa.
Okay, and
is
this for him too?
Yeah.
Your hat head's on TV.
This is a very good lady.
Oh, thank you.
So,
are you guys...
The guards have taken license in the last little while, right?
The guards have?
The voice of steel. All right.
Is this a sound one, too?
Yeah, the paper's out, is it?
No, not yet. Okay. We just announced the launch.
All right.
You missed our launch.
Yeah, now that you missed our launch.
No one told me about it.
Yeah, that's true.
Severe?
Yeah.
Join the United Nations after the split up of the country, so they don't have standard. They're
a lot of the photographs are more disturbing. Best sight I've seen so far. This is a famous saying by Helen.
Helen, hey.
The past is history. The future is a mystery. The present is a gift. That's why you call it the present.
Bravo!
Bravo!
I can't see him on this tree.
for our children. Just kidding.
What a crazy guy.
Yeah, this is funny. Before he went to jail. Coming, the people are coming already.
Thank you. there is a problem over there. There is a guy who is very upset, and he's arguing with one of the guys who thinks bombing is wrong. And everybody's hating him.
I'll finish this, like I said. first of all, what point are you talking about?
Very annoying. I got a brother in Winnipeg on the base.
might be going in. And, you know, we don't care about this. I mean, it's just facing the government property. There are quite a few of us over here getting very pissed off on it.
Thank you.
Oh, falling under the pressure of the cops.
Where do you want to be? Back up there in the sun?
Not just as an interest group or a protest movement, but as conscientious objectors to violence at each and every level of society. We are concerned about the abuse of human rights at home as well as abroad. We know from experience that the only worthy response to violence is nonviolent intervention and honest attempts at reconciliation. The war in Yugoslavia could have been avoided many years ago through support for democratic, nonviolent resistance movements, fair and honest conflict mediation, and humanitarian assistance to all in need. We will continue working, like we have for many years, in preventing conflicts such as the present one in Yugoslavia. We have a vast accumulation of knowledge and experience in conflict areas such as Europe, the Middle East, Southeast Asia, and Latin America, and we encourage everyone to freely utilize suggestions from the people talking and many of the people in the crowd who have been involved in many of these sorts of things to search for peaceful alternatives to war, ending violence at home and around the world, and find the tools needed to foster a culture of peace, human dignity, and respect. We're here to encourage plowshares rather than swords.
Andrew Lauf, before I read this, I'd just like to say that my grandfather joined the Canadian Army when he was 15 to fight in World War I. And I'm here chalking those walls. I think what he did was honorable, and I think this is honorable. And I don't understand people who think that those two feelings cannot be reconciled and exist in the same way, in the same way. And I'd also like to say that I don't believe that the honorability of what veterans and what our ancestors did previously makes this institution untouchable today. And I'd like to read this. Respect for soldiers, past and present. Respect for all Canadians who are members of the armed forces, both past and present,
We are here this evening not to protest the personal occupational choices of soldiers, but to appeal to their love of democracy. Our country is presently at war. It is a war that is occurring not in defense of democracy, but in the systematic targeting of unarmed civilians. Many proud veterans, both in Canada and abroad, have rightly asserted that the present NATO campaign is an act of cowardice and disrespect. We are a group of Canadians who have a very high level of respect for all human life, whether civilian or combatant, patriot or adversary. We do not want to see any more bloodshed or suffering in Yugoslavia. The only way to stop the death and misery is to stop the bombing immediately and work for real peace and reconciliation. When the Canadian Armed Forces are led into battle at the whim of political and military leaders who are not properly trained in conflict resolution and conflict mediation, it is a serious dishonor to all Canadians. This is what the NATO bombing campaign in Yugoslavia is. Instead, we want to see Canada's armed forces involved in humanitarian assistance and peace building. We are here to build human dignity, solidarity, and respect for all human life.
To come on Fridays at 12 o'clock. 12 o'clock, there's an individual continuing for several weeks right here.
What you organize for us. Thank you very much.
Who would drink that away?
How'd you find out about it?
Two
Turkey and
people. Oh, great.
Yeah,
actually,
we didn't know people.
And
Zeus? Or
one?
Yeah,
that's
okay. That's fine. Oh, yeah. I just want to take this. Armoury is good. He was inside in the
end.
You're
good.
I was thinking that too.
Well, you're trying to stick in the picture of this.
You're an anarchist, you don't vote.
I'm a socialist.
When will you come into this? Are you just walking down the street?
No, I'm coming.
Okay. You have to go over there then.
What?
Negotiate the police?
Prior to this, like, say, would be one section, right? You know, that was really, really good smile. Nice and thick. You went in.
Yeah.
What was supposed to be a peaceful demonstration at Hamilton's James Street Armoury turned ugly tonight. Anti-NATO slogans chalked onto the armoury walls incensed the families of war veterans. Videographer Jim Lagojanis reports.
You're not upset. The bombs are falling on civilian buildings, on civilian targets, and you're upset here because there's a little bit of chalk which is going to wash off the next day?
The writing was on the wall, and this son of a World War II veteran didn't like it.
My father left school to go to Europe. The second time in our century that Canadians left, they volunteered. They were not conscripted like the Yugoslav army. They volunteered to go to Europe to stop madness. Twice in our century, over 100,000 Canadians laid down their lives.
Oh, no, it's a nice atmosphere.
More than 50 people, calling themselves the Armouries Conversion Project, chalked the walls of the James Street Armoury with anti-war messages.
It's a temporary statement because it's with water-soluble children's chalk, sidewalk chalk, so it's the lasting effect is not there, but we hope that the message itself will spread and stay with us and then therefore inspire people. And
you expect to get arrested?
We're prepared to be arrested, but it's up to the police. I mean, we don't want to be arrested, but we're prepared for that.
I understood this is supposed to be a nonviolent protest.
That's right. That's right.
A dozen police officers were on hand to ensure that the peace was maintained.
And if it spreads out over a greater, distance here.
Then
but obviously, I didn't say that. And they said, obviously, it's going to be more difficult to control.
Organizers say war veterans fought for democracy, and that's exactly what they're doing.
That this country has gone to war without consulting Canadians about their opinions, about their alternatives to violent conflict, and the fact that we are expressing that democratic right. So we're doing it in a very respectful manner.
Jim Lagajanis on TV News, Hamilton.